everybody, welcome back to my channel. This is Enigma and you're watching Enigma. So you must be wondering why these cards have been set up. By the way, these are going to be tea leaf messages for you that I'm going to pull in the end of the reading. Okay, if you like more of these, just let me know so that I can do more of these. Okay, it depends how you want things to be. So today we're going to do Gemini for May 2021. Let's see what are the messages for you. This is like a bonus reading, okay? So take what resonates, leave what does not, because this is a general reading and may or may not resonate with each one of you, okay? And May horoscopes, short May horoscopes in writing are up on Instagram, so you can go and check it out. Do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want more such videos. And also have a Law of Attraction Manifestation Workshop, which is coming up in the month of May. So I'm going to teach you about 40 plus spells, which are going to help you in different areas of your life. It'll cover almost all the areas. And this is going to be based on totally spiritual background, okay? White spells, white magic, okay? So it's 100% spiritual, just like a prayers that I'm going to guide you through. Simple, effective spells you can use anytime, anywhere. Okay, so yeah, if you're interested, you can message me on Instagram for the details, or you can WhatsApp me for the details, or email me. So let's move forward. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs in Gemini. Let me know. Ooh, a lot of money coming in. Gemini, you have a lot of plans regarding how to make a lot of money. You're very money oriented, goal oriented right now. You're not focused on love. You're not focused on other things. You're simply focused on how can I make more money, because that is your goal, ultimate goal. And I do see money coming in, your wishes coming true. And I see you being very positive about your capabilities, earning money. Okay. And you're going to do that. So I see new ideas coming into picture for you. Okay. Also see a marriage offer coming in, but I do see more like a career oriented reading till now. So I feel, Gemini, your money is on point and you're very focused on getting more and more of it. And I see like luxuries are going to be the main focus on May. So you may buy new stuff, okay? You may renovate your house, you know, buy little things, you know, not a proper renovation. Like you may do simple things to change the look of the house. You may buy some new furniture stuff, okay? Maybe online. You like to, you know, make things attractive around you and your own self. You may buy new clothes online, maybe, okay? So I feel like you're very interested in enhancing yourself, okay? Now here, Ace of Swords and the Moon, which I see over here. You may be dealing with a Scorpio, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. He's constantly thinking about you. You're on someone's mind constantly. I feel like, Gemini, you're very straightforward and you're not going to take any kind of bullshit. So you said something that may have hurt this Scorpio or someone in general. Could be any sign, but someone got hurt by what you said, I feel. And this was right, straight on point, okay? Gemini, you said something that may have hurt the other person, but that may have helped you, you know, physically and mentally. So you did what needs to be done for your sake of healthiness, you know, for yourself, for your positivity, because you don't want any negativity around you. So you may have pushed someone away by saying something. You may have directly cut this person off from your life. So I feel whoever this is, they are thinking a lot about you and they're feeling very, very sad. They may be crying a lot over you, I feel. Scorpio maybe, okay. Someone's thinking deeply, someone wanting to call you, someone wanting to text you, but do not know like how to reach out to you. But they are like a little bit intimidated or scared. They feel left out in the cold, alone and overthinking things. And that is why they're feeling very intimidated reaching out to you. Gemini, I feel like you have a lot of things in hands and you don't have time for drama. So you're focused on your money, you're focused on other love interests, you're focused on whoever gives you positivity. whatever gives you happiness. Okay, so you don't have time for depression or, you know, sadness, someone coming in and going out, troubling you for no reason. So you don't have time for that. So you, for you, it's like ended. But for this person, they're like simply waiting to reach out to you. They want you back and they don't want to end the situation. I see like things are coming into your favor very, very soon. Okay. And I see Gemini, you will stick to your decision, whatever it is. And you're holding up the courage to, you know, feel whatever you're doing or saying is absolutely right and should be there. So you are showing off a lion side, okay, or lioness side, and this person is pretty convinced, okay. Deep down they are hurt, but they're convinced because you're not allowing anybody to treat you like a doormat, okay. So Gemini, I see you very, very focused on work, very goal oriented, and you don't have time to, you know, allow anybody to ramble up your spirit. So you're getting luckier with money. Money is growing. I see new opportunities, new ventures, and I see new options taking interest in you, Gemini. You may be talking to new people. I see like there is a best friend you may be having, okay, someone of same sex, like if you're a female, then this is a female. If you're a male, then this is a male. Not love interest, but I see someone really helping you out, okay, in your career. So yeah, I see you developing more friendships, and money is going to be the center point, and I feel like more and more money you are going to save or invest. And let me see why I get seven of swords and six of swords here. Okay, Gemini, I feel like you have feelings for whoever it is, but you desperately want to talk to this person, but because of this fight that you've had, you want to stick to your opinion because you feel you're right and you don't want to, you know, back down. And I feel you've decided to move on. However, it's very, very difficult for you to move on, but you are moving on. You have feelings. You may be avoiding someone, but you want to move on because you want money, you want happiness, you want prosperity, you want love, you want positivity. So you're very excited about life in general. You're not stressing over things anymore. With the star, I feel like you are the center of attention for so many. And I feel like you may be doing something which is making you popular on social media, or which is making you popular wherever you are right now, working, wherever. I see you being more attractive in the month of May. People are going to be attracted to you even more, and they will be like finding you someone who's different from others, a star-like quality. Maybe some of you may be a celebrity, okay, like that. So you may get popular, okay. Six of Cups, I sense a strong reconciliation happening by this person. Someone wants you back, they miss you, and I feel like they have love for you. They feel like you're the one for them, you're the soulmate for them, so they just cannot move on. But Gemini, you may shut the door on this person, okay, and you've decided you don't want to change your mind. It's done. For you, it's like, I'm done, okay? I don't want to change my mind because you change your, you know, vibe every time. But I cannot change like that. So Gemini, you've decided to move on, and I feel like you're not giving this person another chance, okay? However, this person is in love with you. All right, chemistry. There's a strong chemistry. Even you feel it for them, Gemini, and they do. Yeah, there's a strong magnetic pull this person has towards you. And I see like they will definitely reach out to you for communication. See, I told you, there's a reconciliation happening. They're going to make the efforts, okay? They will definitely make efforts regarding this relationship. And they want you, basically. They trust you. They see. Maybe this is someone who you have been in a relationship or in a connection from the past, and that is why you're the only one that they trust the most, okay, and can never let you go. So they want you to know more of them. They want you to clear certain things about them, okay, certain misunderstandings. There's a lot of romantic feelings this person feels, but however, I feel like they have a lot of family issues, family drama going on, because of which they behave the way they behave. Yeah, so let's see more, Gemini. Yeah. Oops. Oh my God, your energy. Okay, your person is hurt, very hurt, and your person will even they'll get even more hurt if you look out for other opportunities. You always have options, and this is why they always come back, because they get hurt when you leave them. Okay, when you don't focus on them, they feel so sad. I see your brain is working very sharply. Your crown chakra is on point. I feel like whatever you're going to take the decision, it will be based on brain over heart, okay? Mind over heart. You're going to take mind over heart decision, and that is going to really help you grow more and more with time. And all the best, Geminis. Let me see more. Some of you, your person is 24, you're 24, or someone has birthday on 24. See, your dreams need to be practical. So the more you work, the more you're going to get the benefit out of it. And see, like, there's a new beginning happening, maybe a Pisces or a Taurus coming in, or there's a lot of balance that's coming into your life. Maybe a friend of yours is a Pisces that's really helping you, okay, balance things in life. Could be an Aquarius reaching out to you. So there's a lot of love that's coming in. Love and only love, nothing else. So love could be from family, from friends, from your lover, whoever it is. I do see your past person is hurting because you're not there in their life. Right now you're focused on being positive, improving your health, and you've started forgiving anybody who hurts you so that you can easily move on. Doesn't mean that you're taking the person back, but you just want to move on easily so you're okay and you're able to figure. And I see your self-respect is very important to you right now, and you're going to persevere. Whatever you're going to do, you're going to be very confident about it. So that's about it, Gemini. I hope this reading you've enjoyed. And before ending this, I'm going to pick one tea leaf message for you. So I've spread these cards, and let's see which one can I pull for my Gemini in. See, as I told you, you're going to have new creative ideas, new ventures, and a fresh start. So yeah, this is there. Let me just pull one more because this is exciting. Okay, most of you are in a relationship, and yes, of course, that's why you're watching this. So mostly you're females here, or mostly whoever this person is. This could be you or your man, okay? One more, waiting for a new. So yeah, this person is going to bring a message towards you. There's a definite reconciliation happening here. Lighthearted, carefree time. As I told you, you're going to spend a lot of time with your best friend or best friends, even your lover. If they come back, they will. Okay, they will. So there will be a lot of fun time. You guys will have tea together, you know. Your person is definitely hurting over you. As I told you, you're no longer there in their life, so they're like crying or anything. Temporary. So this is temporary, they're going to be back. So your person is going to be back. So yeah, that's about it, Gemini. I hope you've enjoyed it. Do not forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell, and do mention in the comment section how this resonated. Let me know if you want me to come with more such videos. And yeah, bye for till now. And I'll talk to you next time. Till then, stay safe and stay blessed.